Yeah, the final issue of the Farmer's Almanac, used for many things, you know, fun tips on gardening, but also the weather forecast that is usually in the Farmer's Almanac. So after 200 years, now it's starting to end, the last issue of it. Just looking back at how the Farmer's Almanac predicted the weather, it usually was in a long-term form with sections of the U.S., and it used pattern-based forecasting. So it looked at solar activity, lunar phases, even planetary positions, and it had that methodology with its forecasting versus a local meteorologist such as your team here at WBAL-TV 11 News. We use more data-driven forecasts. So we'll look at satellite imagery, radar systems, current weather data from weather stations, and then also forecasting using the modeling, the atmospheric modeling, and that's where you'll usually hear the Euro forecast, the GFS. We put all of those factors together to come up with a forecast for you. So while the Farmer's Almanac, great resource for planting in those long-term ranges, as far as short-term ranges are concerned, that's where your local meteorologist, again, your team here at WBAL, we are one of the great sources for that. So using those data there, you can get more of those pinpoint short-term forecasts.